My name is Ayodele Elegba. I'm from Lagos, Nigeria. I'm an animator, a creator, and I'm also the founder of the biggest comic convention in Africa, titled Lagos Comic Con. I began comics at a very young age when I was in secondary school. I loved drawing, you know. I grew up reading comics like Spider-Man, Superman, Batman, you know, the Marvel and DC comics, you know. And since then, it has always stuck in my mind that I wanted to make comic books and make animation. So when I finished school, I decided that I didn't want to be a microbiologist. I said, no, I want to make art. I want to make comic books. I want to make animation. So I started making comic books. I created my first comic book in 1999. And since then, I've been creating several comic books in Nigeria. I also, in 2012, I realized that not plenty people are confident or brave or happy or proud to say that they read comic books or they draw comic books. You know, people are ashamed of saying that I'm a comic book person or because I love comic books. So I wanted to create a place where people of my age can read comic books and feel like nobody's watching them, or they don't feel ashamed to talk about comic books. So I created the event Lagos Comic Con in 2012. In 2012, we had 300 people attend, and since then, we have grown the event over and over. Last year, 2018, we had 4,000 people come from all over Africa, from Ghana, from Cameroon, from up north. And it was an exciting time because plenty of people understood now that Africa makes comic books, and we have good artists, good colorists, good writers, good animators in Africa. You know, Lagos Comic Con brings people who do comics, animation, games, brings them all together in one place, and they can network and enjoy themselves. I have several comic books because for me, I wanted to make comic books that represented Africa, that represented the challenges that we face as Africans. One of my comic books is called Jinx. It's about a girl, Eno, who was actually supposed to be giving a sacrifice to the gods, you know, but she found favor with the gods, and the gods bestowed her with powers of the Orisha. And now she has spiritual powers, and now she uses the powers to save other weak girls who face different challenges that girls face in Africa. I also have a comic book which I call Strike Guard. Strike Guard is about a young man, an undergraduate in the university, who came across some cultists, you know, in school, and he was killed. You know, but when he was killed, when he was buried and thrown into a ditch, the ditch they buried him was the same spot that that a particular ancestor in the likes of Shango was also buried. So right there, when he fell into the ditch, his spirit merged with the gods, and then he came out and became a superhero. So now he goes around, you know, with thunder and lightning, and then he's saving people in Africa and from the streets. So I have a couple of comic books like that, because for me, I realized that many Nigerians don't read anymore. They find it difficult to read textbooks and learn English or learn other things. For me, I feel comics is an opportunity for you to attract young people to reading, attract them to drawing, and attract them to storytelling. And that's what I try to do with every comic that I produce.